Most who know of the Tennessee Titans defensive coordinator marvel either at his longevity, 59 consecutive NFL seasons as a player or coach, or his Hall of Fame playing and coaching career, 62 career INTs, two-time Super Bowl champion, creator of the zone blitz. Those who know him well describe his role as a father figure, a teacher and a storyteller. Those who have played for him rave about his ability to relate even as an 80-year-old man coaching a roster full of 20-somethings. Those who have coached with him speak about the serenity in which he leads and the wisdom he bestows upon those who surround him. Titans cornerback Logan Ryan summed up the feeling of most who have spent time with LeBeau: you don't know how good of a human being he is until you meet him. He's genuinely a good guy who has no bad days. So for those who haven't met him, ESPN gathered an assortment of memories and stories about LeBeau, perhaps the NFL's greatest storyteller. I wanted to cry. Ike Taylor, former CBN NFL Network analyst, Steelers 2003-14, we were playing at the New York Jets, in 2007. Dickie told me coming out of a TV timeout he was going to put me in a soft coverage. He goes, "Trust your eyes because I have a feeling they're going to do a trick play." I shrugged Dickie off. I hit him with a yeah, yeah. Well, they did a flea flicker. Speedy Laveron used Coles lined up on my side. I bid on the play action run. By the time I saw the running back pitch it back, Coles got behind me. It was a no-shoot moment. He took it to the 1 yard line. Then they scored. I could feel Coach LeBeau looking at me from about 70 yards away. I tried to be the last person on the field to get to that sideline. He looked at me the whole way with an assassin look. My whole insides were hurting. I let down the team, but more importantly, I let Dickie down by ignoring him. He's seen everything, but I was being disobedient. He said this to me calmly: "We can't win ball games with you playing like this," and walked off. I wanted to cry. Legend and Pittsburgh Titans defensive coordinator Dick LeBeau has tinkered with drawing up plays since middle school. Mark Humphrey, AP Cam Hayward, DL, Steelers 2011 present, "I still miss him saying, 'What's up, Buckeye? How you doing?' It's weird to see him with something other than a Steelers uniform on. I'd like to think a lot of our character is made from him. Some of these younger guys don't really know about him, but if you spent 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 years with him, I'd like to think you grew up with him. A lot of our characteristics are Dick LeBeau driven. Even some of our goals and stuff, they are still Coach LeBeau and the way he wanted it because our coaches are under him. I think his imprint is a lasting imprint that our defense wants to reach." Bryce McCain, CB, Steelers 2014, Titans 2016 present, "It was different in Pittsburgh. When he walked through the room or started talking, everybody went quiet. You could hear crickets. No aftertalk. It was weird to me at first. He was a legend in Pittsburgh. You immediately recognized how important he was to the team and franchise." Meet me at Outback Logan Ryan, CB, Titans 2017, "When I signed here, we went to a dinner with all the free agents that signed. Coach, Mike, Malarkey, General Manager, John Robinson, LeBeau and Offensive Coordinator, Terry Robisky were there. I brought my wife. So my wife and LeBeau were laughing. They hit it off talking about Outback Steakhouse. They both love Outback Steakhouse, and completely non-football stuff. My wife was like, 'I love LeBeau.' I was like, 'Do you know who that is? He's a Hall of Famer.' She was just talking about him as a person. It's a cool that he's a Hall of Fame coach and a great football mind, but he can have a conversation with my wife and make her feel comfortable about Outback Steakhouse." Dick LeBeau in his own words: "Favorite memory, I've been in 6 Super Bowls. 2 in Cincinnati, 4 in Pittsburgh, so they are pretty good memories. Favorite player, I've had a lot of great players that have been my honor to coach. It's hard to single out favorites, but my 2 defensive player of the years, James Harrison in 2008 and Troy Polamalu in 2010, would be at the top of the list. And James Farrier, he should have been my 3rd. He really was the most valuable player that year."